What's up, my peoples? As you can see, the setting is different. That's because I'm not home. I'm at school. And I know this review is a little late, but I had to settle in with school. I had to, you know, talk to my peoples that I haven't seen in a while. I haven't seen them in months. But it's better late than never. So let's knock this review out, shall we? Let's get it, man.
What we do here is go back.
Monday Night Raw opens with some good action between Big Match John Cena and Jason Jordan. This was a competitive match. They was still trying to get Jason Jordan over. We know the boy can wrestle, but I don't think this is really going to get him over with the crowd. Even though Jason Jordan did do his shit in this match, this was great. Great showing by Jason Jordan, but I don't think this match is really going to get him over. But Big Match John Cena, of course, gets the win, and gets the shovel and buries another talent. Nah, I'm just joking. He didn't bury nobody, but John Cena wins. He couldn't lose this match. Then comes the big dog, Roman Reigns. He comes down. They do a little promo back and forth. Wasn't as good as last week, but this was Roman Reigns and John Cena. They had a little weird moment when they both talking about Roman's penis, and John Cena was talking about, oh, yeah, your zip is done. The funniest thing with the Roman Reigns was like, yeah, I busted it open, big dog. But that was the funny part from that. But Roman Reigns was like, yo, this is your time, John. Hit me right now. Hit me. John Cena didn't hit him. And Roman Reigns was like, that's what I thought. All that stuff. He walks out. So it's kind of smart what WWE's doing. They, if you realize, they haven't touched each other. Maybe they want to touch each other before the pay-per-view, the go-home episode of Monday Night Raw, but they haven't hit each other. I would have expected a Superman punch or a spear by now by a Roman Reigns or attitude just by John Cena, but it hasn't happened. WWE's doing the smart thing by keeping them away from each other as far as, like, physical. Let me go on to a match between Heath the Baby and Rhino versus Sheamus and Cesaro, which was a squash match. It has Dean Ambrose and Seth Rollins on commentary. This was a pretty squash match. Heath Slater and Rhino get squashed, and Sheamus and Cesaro win. I'm kind of upset what they're doing with Rhino and Heath Slater on Raw. They could have been, they could have lost, but like, come on, man. We love Heath Slater and Rhino a few months ago on SmackDown, man. They was a good ass tag team, and they should turn around how they use Heath Slater and Rhino, because they were definitely a dope tag team. We go to Jeff Hardy and The Miz for the IC Championship. Most of the Mr. Rod gets kicked out and Matt Hardy during the match. That leaves Maryse and out there in Miz's corner. But honestly, this was a solid match, great match between Miz and Jeff Hardy. They had some decent chemistry in that ring. Jeff Hardy lost fairly clean. The Miz hit him with the Skullcrusher finale, like, clean. Like, he didn't really cheat or nothing. So I don't know what they're trying to do with Jeff Hardy, man. You can't have Jeff Hardy losing clean to the Miz, man. I ain't like that too much. But it was a good match by Miz and Jeff Hardy. I kind of wanted Jeff to win the IC title, man. I just feel like there's so many good matches. You got Jeff and Bray, Jeff and Finn, Jeff and Joe, Jeff and Seth, Jeff and Dean. Like, there's so many, like, good matches that you can do with Jeff as an IC champion. So maybe he'll get another shot at No Mercy. We go on to Drew Gulak and Tony Nese, Dar versus Enzo, Cedric, and Grand Metalik. This was an okay cruiserweight match. Enzo gets the win with the Giordano. And yeah, pretty okay cruiserweight match. I'm watching 205 a lot once because Enzo's on. The dude is crazy entertaining, yo. I don't give a fuck. He might be the worst wrestler in that ring. Matter of fact, he might be better than Drew Gulak. I can't stand him. And Tony Nese. They can go fucking kick bricks. They got no charisma whatsoever. But Enzo's entertaining as hell. So that's why I'm watching the cruiserweight division again. We're going to a Finn and Bray promo. Finn is in the ring. Bray comes out on the Titantron. Like, he does this little spooky, hooky-poopy stuff. And Bray was like, basically, Finn, I didn't get beat by you. I got beat by the demon and all this stuff. So they're building a story that only Finn can only be Bray with the demon. Demon. I think they're using, they're doing this whole thing backwards. I think they should have had Finn lose to Bray Wyatt as regular Finn at SummerSlam, and then at No Mercy pull out the Demon. But they're doing everything ass backwards, so I don't know. Maybe Finn is gonna get the win at No Mercy. Maybe he's gonna get the win at No Mercy when he's regular Finn. Then we got Bliss and Sasha Banks versus Nia Jax and Emma. Emma and Jax wins. They will get inserted into the women's title match at No Mercy. They ended up getting the W. Emma steals the pin from Nia Jax, so they are inserted into the No Mercy women's Raw women's title match. And I don't know who the fuck to pull for. This women's division is all over the place. I don't know. I guess just keep it on Bliss. I'll just keep it on Bliss forever until Paige comes back, honestly. Because they got nobody on Raw that I can really, really care about now. Like, Sasha's been giving me mixed feelings lately. And it's just crazy. I don't know who. Maybe I'll have a different opinion next week. We going to Dean and Seth versus the Ski Brothers. That's what I call Anderson and Gallows, the Ski Brothers. And Dean and Seth wins because Sheamus and Cesaro for some reason tried to distract Dean and Seth, but they ended up helping Dean and Seth win. So then we had a fight between the Ski Brothers and Sheamus and Cesaro, and they ended up fighting, and Sheamus and Cesaro ended up beating their ass. So I guess it's supposed to make Sheamus and Cesaro look strong, but didn't do well for the Ski Brothers. Then we go to the Big Show versus Braun Strowman. This was an okay steel cage match out of the three main events that they had. This is probably my least favorite match. Probably the one when they broke the ring was my favorite, or probably the first one, but this is definitely my least favorite. Braun Strowman wins. It took him a while to beat Big Show, but he did get the W. And it was a cool spot when Big Show did a flying elbow drop from the top of the turnbuckle. That was kind of cool, man. Giants can fly. But Braun wins, and then after the match, he cuts a promo on Brock Lesnar. Then he picks up Big Show and chucks him outside the ring and just threw him through the cage. So that was a cool spot. So Braun looks strong. I'm still pulling for my man Braun Strowman to win the Universal title and save us all from this reign of terror that is Brock Lesnar as Universal Champion. So that was Monday Night Raw. It was a pretty okay show. But it was a pretty decent show. So I'm gonna give that a thumbs middle. SmackDown Live opens up with two old school style promos with Randy Orton and Shinsuke Nakamura, both of them in some backstage setting. Randy Orton is kind of promo in a different setting. Shinsuke is on another part of the arena. It was kind of cool. It was very old school, I like that. They need to do more promos like this. I was really into this. Then we go to the ring and Carmella and Ellsworth, and then KO comes out and was like, nah, I'm the special guest referee for this match. And Shane McMahon comes down and was like, no, we're not gonna do this. And then they get into a promo back and forth. Kevin Owens just basically goes off on Shane McMahon. He mentions his kids, his family. And then when that happened, Shane was like, don't ever mention my kids and my family ever again. So then Kevin Owens mentions the helicopter crash with Shane McMahon earlier this year. And it was like, your family would be better off if you wasn't, if you didn't survive that crash. That was insane, yo. That was a pretty hard blow right there for Kevin Owens, man. And then mixes his kids once again. Shane McMahon goes ballistic. He goes crazy. He beats the holy hell out of Kevin Owens. And that's crazy, man. That was one hell of a way to start off. I feel like a lot of things happened within the first 10 minutes of SmackDown. So SmackDown definitely had a hot start. Then we go back to the ring with Carmella and Natty. And they have been a decent match. The story here is that Ellsworth, towards the end of the match, he tries to give Carmella the briefcase to cash it in. Carmella was like, what are you doing, James? What are you doing, James? And James was like, go cash it in. Then the distraction caused Natty to win. After the match, Carmella just goes ballistic on James Ellsworth, call him every name in the book, man. Call him not a human, genetically mutated, whatever. And she basically breaks it off with him. But later in the night, James finds Carmella They talk it out. He apologizes. Then she kisses him. She kisses him and then slaps him. But I was jealous, man. Carmella's a hot chick. I would definitely love a kiss from Carmella. But, but yeah, so the weird pairing between James Ellsworth and Carmella. But, we go on to Dolph Ziggler's re-debut. He comes out as regular Dolph, but the thing is, after he comes out, he's like, that's it? You like, you wanted a gimmick? That's all you care about these days is gimmick, people. So he goes out, he comes back out as John Cena, which was hilarious. He goes back out and come back as Macho Man Randy Savage. Then after that, he comes back out, and this is my favorite one, he came out as Trent, and he did the whole glow thing, which was fucking insane, yo. I was dying laughing. Yo, Dolph Ziggler going out and come back. I could have did that. He could at least gave me about like 5 more gimmicks. You know, that joint was freaking crazy entertaining. Then he was just like, yo, you people just make me sick. And then he just left. So that was a good segment for Dolph. I was definitely entertained. We go on to Aiden English and Sami Zayn. Rematch from last week. Aiden English gets a quick roll-up victory over Sami Zayn. I mean, like, can this guy Sami Zayn get buried any further? He's jobbing quickly to another jobber. That is crazy. Like, how are you jobbing to a jobber? That I've never seen that. Sami Zayn is one of the best wrestlers in the like on the planet right now, and it's criminal how WWE is using him. So we go into a backstage segment with the Thug Uso, Jimmy Thug, Oops, J Thug, Oops, and the New Day. They're gonna get the stipulation for their for the tag team title match next week in Sin City, and it is a Sin City street fight with them Thug Uso. Them Thug Usos better retain, enough with this hot potato bullshit. Get them New Days out the way so we can get a new tag team and a title picture, man. Definitely. I need them Thug Usos to retain. Then we go to Daniel Bryan and Shane McMahon in the ring. Daniel Bryan calls out Shane, and Daniel Bryan basically tells Shane, I got a call from your father, and basically, like, you know, since Kevin Owens, he threatened to sue the family early in the show, Vince McMahon told Daniel Bryan to indefinitely suspend Shane McMahon. And, that's about it. And it was I kind of like where the storyline is going a lot. I kind of like it because next week we're going to get Mr. McMahon. He's definitely going to show up to SmackDown. And that's like a first. And like, I don't remember the last time Vince McMahon showed up on SmackDown. So Sin City SmackDown is looking really, really good next week. I'll definitely be into that shit. It looks like a pretty stacked show. You got Mr. McMahon, you got mad title matches and everything. So I'm pretty excited for SmackDown next week. Then we go on to Baron Corbin versus Ty Dillinger. Baron Corbin gets a win over Ty Dillinger. It was a pretty solid match. I think Baron Corbin did a little cheap shot, hit Ty Dillinger in his throat or something, and like threw Ty off. And then he hits him with the End of Days, and then Baron Corbin gets the win. But we go backstage to AJ Styles. He finds Ty Dillinger. It was like Baron Corbin's always taking cheap shots. So next week, this is what I'm going to do. The open challenge is open for you, Ty, and we're going to give the fans what we want. This is what I want. I want Ty Dillinger versus AJ Styles. I want them to give them time. Give them at least 10 minutes. At least 10 minutes. Not like fucking half a minute like they did the last time. 10 minutes with Ty Dillinger and AJ Styles and watch them do magic. I don't want no commercial breaks either. Then you go on to the main event, which is Shinsuke Nakamura and Randy Orton. And this was a pretty fun match to watch. Shinsuke Nakamura picks up the win over Randy Orton. So Nakamura has pinned both John Cena and Randy Orton clean over the last month. So Nakamura is looking like a pretty big damn deal, even though I feel like when you look at his matches, he's been getting watered down, his moveset. But on paper, he's beating these top people. So I guess Vince McMahon still has a little bit of faith still left in Shinsuke Nakamura. But we shall see. I'll really say Nakamura has the full faith from Mr. McMahon once he pins Roman Reigns. But there will be Jinder Mahal. This will be Jinder Mahal and Nakamura at Hell in a Cell. Hopefully this is in a Hell in a Cell, because I think that they can do something. They can do a little bit more interesting shit in a Hell in a Cell compared to their match at SummerSlam. And hopefully Shinsuke picks up the win at Hell in a Cell and becomes WWE champion. So if I have to pick a show which was better from top to bottom, SmackDown definitely kicked Raw's ass this week. More consistent. I love that consistency. And this was, it was a decent show. Raw was okay. It wasn't a bad show. It was okay. But SmackDown definitely brought it this week. So, and I can't wait for both Hell in a Cell and No Mercy. So we did good building towards their papers, but SmackDown was a solid show. Yeah. Jesus. So if you like this, hit it with a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe, show a brother some motherfucking love. And follow me on my social media that we posted after the video gets the black and I won't get the hell up out of here. And as you can see, I don't have my belt. My belt is home and I miss it and I feel like this review and I didn't have my full power, my belt. I need my belt right now. So if I seem less energetic, that means I don't have my baby on me, man. But yeah, so if you, like I said before, if you enjoyed it, hit it with a thumbs up. Show a brother some love, man. And take it easy, my peoples. We are out of here. Boom!